Good morning, everyone. It's Vlogmas day 15, I believe. I think it's this. No, it was not. It's this. This is number 15. So that I will open. It's pretty dark inside today because it's snowing. So. Awesome. It's vanilla bean, this one, and this is coconut and pear. Oh, I was so hoping that I would get some of these because my chocolate, dark chocolate and blueberry, I'm all out of that. I have two others, but that is it. I hope you can see. Yeah, you can. It's it doesn't get any better than this because it is, as I said, dark inside because it's snowing. Thank you so much, Anne. I love them as everything else you have given me. And I also got another package today from my sweet friend Suzanne. She has the Green Lambkin podcast. I got this Christmas gift. I got this cute and sweet card. And I got these. Now, she said I could open them before Christmas. She said I can open them whenever I want to. But I have decided that I'm gonna wait until Christmas. And we celebrate the most on the 24th. So I'm gonna open them then. And I'm so very excited. So very excited. And, oh, I should have brought that. I'm gonna pause that and go get it. Okay, I just realized I have some of her yarn because she's an indie dyer. I'm not sure if I have showed this on the podcast or not. I think I haven't. She dyed up my dream colorway from a picture I sent her. So she named this Disa's Dream. Oh, you can't see it. It is this gorgeous. Well, I'm gonna have to, oops, sorry, I would have to take this to where it's, yes, now you can see, this is gorgeous, this is not neon, but it is a bright, lovely yellow, and this has browns, and different shades of green and kind of yellowish, greenish and darker green going into brown, and there are gray, and it's just gorgeous. And now Grim is whining, although he has been outside for 1 hour and I have been playing with them all the time, and he's trying to fool me that he has to go outside, but I will let him out. Hold on. Okay, I let him and Leonie out again. Now they are playing outside alone. And we are now past 6 weeks since he did the chipped castration, so now he is not gonna be able to have any babies. And for 24 hours, I have not seen that she has any of her period left, or how you say it in English. So I think it's safe. Neither of them should be able to make babies. So today, I can relax and not watch them all the time, and it's so awesome. Anyway, back to this amazing yarn that I love so much, so much, and I'm dying to knit with it. At the same time, I want to hoard it. I just want to save it so I can just look at it. But yeah, I can't decide. But it's so lovely. And I think that maybe after Christmas or something, if I can afford to buy any yarn, I'm gonna see if she can dye me another skein, and then I will knit immediately with one of them, because then I have another. She also sent me this very, very cute, what do you call these in English? I cannot remember. Erasers, of course, duh. Like I said when I podcast, English names escape my mind. These are so, so adorable. And then she made me a bunch of stitch markers. Look at how cute this bird is. But I'm using everyone. She made me progress keepers. I'm gonna open it. She made me progress keepers and stitch markers, and I'm using them all. I only have this to show you now. So pretty. Very pretty. And she made everyone. And I will try to remember to show them as when I use them in the project. But why do I think there was something else in the package? It was a card, of course. It feels like I'm forgetting something. I'm sorry, Suzanne. I'm probably forgetting something right now because my brain is not working very well. But she has a podcast and she has she's an indie dyer. So go check her out, Green Lambkin Yarns. And her podcast is Green Lambkin Podcast. So check her out. And I'm very curious. And of course, I have been squeezing this and it feels like a skein of yarn. So I'm very, very, very curious. But I'm gonna save it for the 24th. And then I wanted to show you, because there's this artist, or yeah, he's an artist, or was an artist. I think he's dead. I'm not completely sure, but he did drawings and paintings and for many children's books. And this is a book I have that is called Bland tomtar och troll, which means among gnomes and trolls or something like that. And let's see, I am trying to see if there's a... No, it doesn't say. It says that this book has been published every year for 75 years. And the artist's name is John Bauer. And he has lovely, lovely drawings. Let's see if I can find the one I am thinking about. Oh, this one I love. But I was thinking about, you can see there is some drawings a little here and there, but this I love so much. I just love them. I think they are just adorable and so well made, and he's an amazing artist. And if you have been following me, you have probably seen my 10 sticks askar. What's it called in English? Matches. Match boxes, maybe. And it has his illustrations on it. And I have had these for many years. And I just put in new matches in them. So I change out this box. But this is the same, as you can see, it's been used a lot. But I absolutely love these. I think they are so lovely. I don't know if you can get these now. I bought them new, but I bought them at a store we have in Sweden that is like Etsy, but it's called Tradera. So that's where I found them. And I think I have 3 illustrations, but I don't know where I put the third, or maybe it was 4. Maybe it was 4. I have to look for them. But look at this. So cute! I love them very much. So these I use daily. And I have been for maybe 7, 8, 9 years. I don't know how long, but I really love them. So I just wanted to share that with you, because you have probably seen, because I keep one of them there, so you have probably seen it when I record. So I will check in with you all later. And just as I stop to record this, I'm not sure I said thank you. Did I say thank you, Suzanne? I'm not sure, but I'm so confused today. Thank you so very much, Suzanne. Thank you so much for everything. And thank you, Anne, for today's package. Thank you so much to both of you. Oh, I have one of these left. And the other package, I ate them all. I actually gave our youngest son 3. Because he was home and he was very happy. He didn't know about them. So then I just came into his room giving him them. And he said that he had watched a podcast where someone was baking with them. And he really wanted to try them out. So it was perfect timing. And he thought they were very yummy. And I did as well. And the other kind. So they are gone. Okay. I guess you can see how much it's snowing. And for as much as it has snowed the last few weeks, we should have a lot more than we do, because some evenings it has started to rain. So if we got like 3 inches of snow, those 3 inches rained away during the night, melted away during the night, and then the next day we got snow, and then in the evening it rained. And then of course there have been many days where it has not been raining in the evening. But this situation up here I'm not happy about, because I have been outside already today. And hit it down. I don't know how to say it. And now it's like this again. It's very annoying when I'm home alone and have to do stuff like that alone. No, I mean by myself. Otherwise hubby would do it, but... So that's annoying, because I will probably have to go outside in a while and do it again. And that is because we have mild weather. It's 0 degrees Celsius or 1 minus. So then the snow is coming off the roof. Quite annoying. But now I'm going to rest and watch something. Well... I totally have no brain. Suzanne also sent me these. And this is not showing up. Because this is this color. And it's not showing. It looks paler than they are. These are gorgeous. She actually knitted me these. wrist warmers exactly to how I like them. And in the Disa's dream yarn that she dyed and created, it's very special to me. And I am dying to use them, but I have decided a long time ago when I got them, because this I didn't get now, as I told you it was before, that I am saving them for Christmas the 24th, which is the day we celebrate Christmas the most in Sweden. I am gonna use these for the first time on Christmas. So I am saving them. I love them very much. I cannot believe I stood here and just said that. It feels like I forget something. Well, of course, duh. Oh, I'm sorry, Suzanne. My brain is just not working. But these are absolutely gorgeous, absolutely lovely, and I love them, and I'm gonna put them on Christmas morning. Just wanted to say that, since I totally had no brain a few minutes ago.